getting a little closer to him, but they're not. They're still about an eighth of a mile away with the LAPD airship, Air 18 overhead. And as I mention his name, you'll see his light. So that is the night sun there from the police helicopter that is now going to be shining down on this vehicle so that other drivers in the area know that this is a pursuit. Yes, we will. He's coming up to Santa Susana Pass here in the next few minutes. The next street coming up, I believe, is going to be Topanga before he gets up there. But in this type of vehicle, he'll be able to maintain freeway speeds as he makes his way up the pass. It is an incline, so there is the chance it could slow him down a touch. But for now, about freeway speeds on the westbound side of the 118 freeway in the Porter Ranch area. A pursuit of a Grand Theft Auto. A possible stolen car. The truck itself is a larger vehicle. It appears to be a Chevy truck with some equipment there in the back. The one thing I can make out is that ladder. As far as anything else, it's really hard for me to see. But the windows are dark, so it's hard to see if anybody else has hopped into the vehicle with him. But the initial reports were that it was just a male driver behind the wheel of this possible stolen truck. Yeah, these units are getting a lot closer, so they're really not going to try a pit maneuver. The speeds are too high and the vehicle is too large. If they get him off the freeway, though, and he slows his speeds down, then they could definitely try it there, despite the fact that the vehicle is a little bit larger than what they would like. But again, spike strips are also in the equation, and they could clear out the traffic in front of him and then lay out a set of spike strips. They could even do multiple spike strips across all lanes if they had to, so that he'd be guaranteed to run over them. But at this point, it looks like for the most part, he's sticking to that left lane. So there's a good chance that if they're going to deploy one, they know he's going to stay in that lane. So this would be a good opportunity to lay one out in front of him. We have not heard mention of a weapon, which we would have heard right off the bat when they mentioned that it was a Grand Theft Auto. They would typically mention that it was an auto that was taken by force or that was taken with the use of a weapon, because that would really escalate things. But in this case, they didn't mention that a weapon was involved. And he may actually be exiting here. So he may be exiting at Topanga Canyon, or he may be coming to a stop. So this is, again, the westbound side of the 118 freeway at Topanga Canyon. Just on the east side of the Santa Susana Pass, you see the units they're getting into place. I believe he may be moving around. I thought I saw him there for just a moment. I thought I saw his arm, and you can see it there. Yeah, and maybe going again, though, at very slow speeds. We don't know how much gas this vehicle had when it was taken, or if it was even taken today. There's a possibility that he's been driving it now for a few days, so who knows what his fuel situation is at this point. Those cars that don't get very good gas mileage. We're talking maybe about 18 miles a gallon or so. So there's a possibility that he could just simply run out of gas, and this is what brings things to an end. But exiting here on Topanga Canyon, and going to be getting into the surface streets here, just off of the 118 freeway on the northbound side. Yeah, so he'll go under it for just a moment, but he'll have a chance to get back on if he wants to. This will be his chance right there, but he's about to miss it, and he sure does. So it was not his intent to get back on the freeway. Instead, he's going to be traveling south on Topanga Canyon Boulevard, south of the 118 freeway. At this point, I'm going to say it's going to be a spike strip that would be best because his speeds do fluctuate unless he can get down to those perfect speeds, which ideally it's about 35. If he's going a little bit slower than that, that works too. But they usually don't want anything faster than that. And what they're going to look for is if they decide to do a pit maneuver, they're going to want it to be a nice wide open stretch road where there are no other vehicles around. And even though there's really no other traffic out in ahead of him, you can see that there's no center divider on this stretch of Topanga Canyon. So they wouldn't want to make him spin and then hit a vehicle that is traveling northbound on Topanga Canyon. So for now, I think their best bet is going to be to try to deploy a set of spike strips up ahead of him. Yeah, still very slow speeds here at Topanga Canyon at Tulsa. So we're in the Chatsworth area. And I was going to mention about spike strips. Even if they do deploy them, that won't immediately bring the pursuit to an end because it won't make the tires just explode or immediately deflate. They will slowly start to deflate. So it could be a situation that takes quite a while. Just a couple weeks ago, we covered a pursuit of a big rig. And of course, the big rig's going to have a lot more tires than this truck. But even though that driver had hit multiple spike strips during the course of the pursuit, it still took about 12 hours to take him into custody. So this is a situation where even if they do run over the spikes, it could take a little bit. Yes, I've seen it done, but it does take multiple attempts. Usually one pit maneuver isn't going to be enough. Because the way that the pit maneuver works is once you cause the vehicle to spin, modern vehicles are equipped to just shut off. So then you want to be able to just continue. And so in this case, it would be a little bit difficult for them to do it with the size of the vehicles that are behind them. I want to check to see if they're SUVs. Okay, so they are the police SUVs. So those are going to be better than your regular sized squad car to attempt a pit maneuver. But again, at this point, they haven't talked about it yet. They've talked about spikes, but pit maneuver hasn't been mentioned in the conversation just yet, for the scanner traffic, that is. Yeah, it really does make things a little tough when the vehicle is a larger car like this. So they can still do it, but in this case, I haven't heard them mention it. I did hear them talk about spike strips, though, when he was on Osborne. So that is when the pursuit first kicked off in the Pacoima area. They did mention setting up spike strips ahead of him on Osborne because they thought he was going to stay on Osborne, considering that he was slow speeds, he had his hazards on. So they thought, oh, well, this guy's just going to stay on Osborne. We'll set some out in front of him. He'll run him over. End of story. But he jumped on the northbound 5 freeway. So that really did change things because now they need, if these officers aren't equipped with spike strips, they're going to need officers from the LAPD's Devonshire Division, where we find ourselves now, to come out and assist with those spike strips, set them up ahead of him, and hopefully they'll time it right and he'll run him over. That's what we've heard so far is one occupant, and that's all I've been able to see. And I can't tell if his window is down or not. It looks like it is, but you can kind of see. Yeah, you can kind of see him there. And I did hear a description of him earlier. They said it was a man wearing a t-shirt, a hat, and he had a beard. So that's as far as we know about this individual at this time. It does change things because since they're back in LAPD's jurisdiction, even though they're not in the Foothill Division of the LAPD and they're actually in the Devonshire Division of the LAPD, LAPD is going to stick with it. So if he were to hop back on the freeway, whether it be the 118 or one of the other nearby freeways like the 405, then the CHP could get into the pursuit at that point. And if they do, the CHP isn't going to want LAPD officers to continue to pursue with them. They would want to take over the pursuit completely. So if they do hand it over to the CHP, it's going to be their handle unless he exits back on a surface street somewhere. If that happens, then whatever the jurisdiction is, the agencies from that area could take over, whether it be LAPD, LA County Sheriff's Department, or if he creeps into an area that's got its own police department, like Santa Monica Police, for example. Yeah, he's gotten pretty lucky. Yeah, because he stayed on Topanga Canyon, that would be the perfect street to try to do it on. Yeah, Topanga Canyon looks like it's going to be a good bet if they do want to do a spike strip. But even if we hear them say on the scan or where they're going to lay it out exactly, we won't mention it until after he passes that point, because there could be a situation where somebody that he is in communication with is watching our broadcast, and we wouldn't want to relay the information about where that strip is. So we'll wait until after he passes it, and then we'll point it out for you. But for now, continuing here southbound on Topanga Canyon, coming up to Nordoff and Chatsworth. Yeah, I think the lights might be timed here through Topanga Canyon to make it easier on the commuters here. They get all green lights or they get all reds, right? And so in his case, it looks like he's been pretty lucky in terms of traffic and in terms of traffic lights. He's gotten all green lights, and when he was on the freeway, he really didn't encounter much traffic at all on that westbound side of the 118 freeway. And now that he's been on Topanga Canyon, his side of the freeway is pretty wide open, and the traffic that we have seen has been on the opposite side of the road here. Exactly. So if he sees the strips up ahead, and in the dark of the night, it might not be as easy for him because they're black, so they may be obscured by the shadows of the night. But if he does see it, if he's going so slow, he's going to be able to just simply go around them. They're not very long. They're essentially the length of the lane. So if he sees one in his lane, so he's in the far left lane, if he sees one in his lane, he could easily maneuver over to the right. So he's actually maneuvering over to the right now. So I'm just going to look up ahead, see if perhaps he sees something that we don't. But in terms of the intersection coming up there, I'm not seeing anything at all. So he's just moving over to the right because he's going to turn. So making that turn there onto Chase Street from Topanga Canyon Boulevard. Yeah, it's kind of ironic. We've got a Chase on Chase Street, and this is a smaller street. So this is going to be a residential street, unfortunately. I never like to see pursuits on residential streets because at this time of the night, you're just getting home from work, and you decide to go on an evening stroll, and that's when you run into the possibility of pedestrians. But he's coming to a stop here, and I do see that other car there, that black vehicle, but it looks like he's just going to be stepping out. And you may be complying here. So it looks like he is going to surrender. I'm going to widen out just for a second till I feel a little bit more comfortable, make sure that he's not going to make a dramatic move there at the end. But it looks like he is complying with authorities. And they're going to take their time here. He's out of the vehicle, so they can set up their officers behind him. If they have a police canine, they can set up the canine as well. And if you notice, he's continuing to move around, which is why I'm kind of skeptical about his true intentions here, about whether or not he's going to try to hop back in the vehicle here or just take off running, because they're essentially asking him not to move right now, and he's still moving. So they want him to just, and he's back up. So let's see what he does. Yeah, so he's, it could possibly be a language barrier. We do see that from time to time where he just perhaps doesn't understand what he's being told to do. But he is walking back towards them now in a strange fashion, to say the least.